Let us try to understand the variation of pressure with depth in a fluid. Now we consider a fluid in a container in which we consider a cylindrical part of the fluid. This is the imaginary part, cylindrical part of the fluid. Now it is inside the fluid. Now this cylindrical part of the fluid having the height h. Now let us discuss about variation of pressure with depth in a fluid. To understand this, we consider a container in which a liquid is or a fluid is present, in which we consider an imaginary cylindrical part of the fluid. Now this is the imaginary cylindrical part of the fluid which is having the height h. Now this is the surface 1 and this is the surface 2. Now on this cylindrical part there is a pressure due to the fluid in all directions which is perpendicular to the surface of the cylinder. Now on the top surface 1 the pressure is p1 which acts always in downward direction. On the bottom surface 2 the pressure acting is p2 which always act in the upward direction. Now the curved surface of the cylinder also experiences the pressure, but which is equal in all directions and which is cancelled. And here these lines with increased length shows that the pressure is increasing as we go down. See, as we come to the down, the length of the lines is increasing. This indicates that pressure is increasing. Now the pressure in all directions is same, equal in opposite directions. This will be cancelled. Now the resultant pressure is acting on the top surface and on the bottom surface only. But we observe that on the top surface pressure P1 acting in downward direction, this is less pressure, and the pressure P2 which is acting on the bottom surface, it is a more pressure, and here P2 is greater than P1. P2 is greater than P1. So the resultant pressure acting on it is P2 minus P1 is the resultant pressure. Now this pressure arises due to a upward force acting on the cylinder in upward direction. Due to this pressure difference, the cylinder experiences an upward force in the upward direction. Now here, now this cylinder is at rest, means here the fluid is not flowing, fluid is static. If the fluid is static and this cylindrical imaginary cylindrical part is static, which is at rest. It is at rest means it is not going up and not coming down, means the resultant force acting on it is zero. If we suppose for the imaginary cylindrical part, for the cylindrical part, if mass is m, its weight mg acts vertically downward. Even though mg is acting down, this cylindrical part is not coming down, means it is experiencing an equal upward force. This equal upward force arises due to the pressure difference. Now how much equal upward force acts here? That is given by the equal upward force is P2 minus P1 into A. Here what is A here? A is the area of each face. Area of each face is the A. Here we calculate like this. The force acting on the top face F1 is equals to P1 into A, and the force acting on the bottom surface is P2 into A, and here the resultant force is F2 minus F1. F2 minus F1 is equals to P2 minus P1 into A. Now this is the resultant upward force. Resultant upward force acting on the cylinder is P2 minus P1 into A, and this is balanced with the downward force mg. So we write P2 minus P1 into A is equals to the mg. Now P2 minus P1 is equals to, I can write mg by A. Now what is m here? M is the mass of this cylindrical part. Now if we suppose rho is the density of the fluid, density of fluid is given by the formula mass by volume, any density mass by volume. Now I suppose for this cylinder mass is m, volume is m. Now it can be written as rho is equal to mass by volume of the cylinder is area of cross section into height, a into h. Now I can write m is equal to rho a h. If I substitute here, I can write P2 minus P1 is equal to rho AH g by A. Here A is cancelled. Now P2 minus P1 is equals to rho HG. It can also be written as rho GH. Now P2 is equals to, I can write P1 plus rho GH. From this equation, we understand P2 is greater than P1. means as we go into the deep, the pressure increases. Now, P1 is the pressure on the top surface of the cylinder, P2 is the pressure on the bottom surface, P2 is equal to P1 plus some value rho g h. At a depth h, pressure, total pressure is P2 is equal to P1 plus rho g h. As this height increases, means as the depth increases, the pressure also increases, so that as we go into the deep, the pressure increases. In this way, we understand variation of pressure with the depth. So the conclusion is that as we go into the deep, the pressure increases. As the depth h increases, pressure also increases here. Now, here, if we take a condition that the top surface of the cylinder is in contact with the atmosphere, means the top surface of the cylinder is on the free surface of the fluid, like this. Now, this is imaginary cylinder. Its top surface is on the free surface of the liquid, means the top surface is in contact with the atmosphere. So on the top surface, the pressure acting P1 is nothing but it is atmospheric pressure PA. P1 is equal to atmospheric pressure PA. And the pressure acting on the bottom face, it is P2, let it be P. Now, this equation is modified as P2 is equal to P1 plus rho gh. Can be modified in this situation, P2 is equals to P. Is equals to P1 means atmospheric pressure PA plus rho g h, where h is the height of the cylinder. Now we can write P is equal to PA plus rho g h. P minus PA is equals to rho g h. Means it is a special condition that whenever the top surface of the cylinder touches with the atmosphere, is on the top surface of the liquid, so that on the top surface pressure acting is PA, on the bottom surface pressure acting P2 is equal to, if we suppose P, now P minus PA is equal to rho g h. This pressure difference is called here gauge pressure. The pressure difference P minus PA is called here gauge pressure. Now, in this way, we understand the variation of pressure with the depth.